Time for power rankings. Time to completely overreact after week one. And of course, these power rankings are solely off of week one. The performances from teams there, and we'll be revisiting these as the weeks go on, adjusting them, I'm sure, depending on how teams perform. But after week one, let's start with EU, which is just everyone beats everyone, as is the theme in EU. You got 8 1-1 teams, which is absolutely insane. But at the top, it's still the Kings, G2. I know they're only 1-1 and they lost the game to Rockat, but they put up a super solid performance against Misfits, and they could have won that Rockat game. Rockat played super well, so kudos to them, but G2 still had a chance to win that game. Misfits, they were close against G2. It kind of got out of their hands pretty quickly though, but then they put up a very solid performance against Schalke, who did have a sub, but we'll get back to that later. Vitality, the only 2-0 team after the initial week. It wasn't against the toughest competition, taken on H2K and Giants, but they did completely dismantle H2K, and maybe 3 is a little high for them here, but the sheer fashion that they put forward this 2-0, you gotta give them some love. Fnatic in at number 4, even in their win, they didn't look that dominant, or you can't feel that confident in them with that win over Splice, and I expect a little more out of Fnatic. I highlighted Caps. That was the best part out of Fnatic. Reckless looked not like the Reckless that we saw in 2017 summer or at Worlds. I don't know how much of that is working with a new bottom lane in Hillisang, but Fnatic got a lot of issues that they have to fix, and Macro's definitely one of them. Schalke, they're a little complicated because they did have Vander role swapping to that AD carry spot, but they did destroy Rockat in that opening week with Vander as a sub, and he looked great on the Varus, taking notes from Forgiven and their time back together. But Schalke should probably be higher, but just because they have a sub, it kind of complicates things. I expect them to rise in the power rankings. I expect them to sit around top 3. Rockat, they beat G2. They seem to do it once a split, so they got this one out of the way early with. They're in at 6. H2K, able to knock off Fnatic, which is very impressive, but they looked absolutely terrible against Vitality in that opening game. Splice, oh yuck. They had a questionable game against Fnatic that they ended up losing, and even the game that they won is a 60-plus minute game against the Unicorns of Love, who looked absolutely terrible. That's why they're coming in at 10, so not too much faith in Splice after the opening week. And then Giants sitting at 1-1. The lone win against the Unicorns of Love. I expect them to kind of hang around in the bottom 2-3 area for the majority of the split. But again, I'll just say Unicorns did not look very good. But EU, very interesting after week one with those 8 1-1 teams. And we thought it would be the most competitive split in EU to date. And it looks like it's going to be after week one. But I still think that G2 Misfits are going to be hanging out at the top.
Make sure to like, comment, and subscribe for more esports content.